The Federal Bureau of Prisons SHU program is a place of desperation, violence, and sleepless nights. So let's talk about it. Hey, what's up, everybody? Shout out to all the law-abiding criminals out there. As always, you know what to do. If this is your first time on the channel and you want to hear more prison stories, learn about prison, the inside workings, and also hear news in the world of corrections across America, go ahead and subscribe. And click that notification bell so you don't miss anything. So guys, if you like this channel, you like the prison life movement, you like what we have going on, do not forget that in the links in every single video, you can donate to the channel in a numerous ways, however you feel moved. We also have merchandise that you can get that represent the law-abiding criminal. And you could also pick up a copy of my book, which is very motivational. It is about my story, my life in prison, and what I did, the mental mindsets that it took to get me through that. So today we are going to be talking about the Federal Bureau of Prisons SHU program. I know it sounds weird to call it a program, but that is exactly what it is. The SHU, S-H-U, is just an abbreviation that stands for Special Housing Unit. Now, this is like a county jail that is on every single prison yard. It's kind of like a county jail and a prison, actually, within the prison, because there are two separate sides. You will have administrative detention or administrative segregation for all you guys that have been in the state prison, but in the federal system, it's called administrative detention. That's just kind of a pre-trial situation where you are before you get found guilty by the DHO. We will get into what the DHO is here in a little bit. But then you also have the disciplinary segregation side, which is after you've been sentenced. You lose even more of your privileges and you have to go over there to serve out whatever sentence it is that they have given you in segregation. And so before I get into how it is to serve time in the SHU and to be there and what the process is like coming in, I'm going to get into what gets you put in the SHU and how you can end up there. Now, in the federal prison system, you have what's called a SHOT. I honestly do not know the name for it as far as being the legal name, what the staff members call it. I'm sure that it was on the write-up somewhere, but basically it's a disciplinary write-up. Inmates call it a SHOT. I don't know where that originated from. If anybody knows, you can drop it in the comments and let me know. But we all call them a SHOT. And it's basically anything that you do wrong, you can get written up for it. And in the Bureau of Prisons, there are four levels of SHOT that you can get. You have a 100 series, which is your greatest. You have a 200 series, which is considered high. You have a 300 series, which is considered moderate. And then you have a 400 series, which is considered low or low moderate. Now, the difference in those, obviously, are going to be what you did. A fight, I'm pretty sure, is a 200. Things like a murder or an aggravated assault, high nature, you know, aggravated assault on staffs, things like that, are going to be your 100s. Escape attempts are going to be your 100. This is the greatest offense you can get. I'm pretty sure that an inmate-on-inmate regular fight is a 200. I could be wrong. It's been a long time since I've been in the system. Your 300s, I'm pretty sure things like possessing wine, if I remember correctly, alcohol is kind of a serious offense, but not an aggravated assault level or anything. Your 400s are going to be things like possession of small contraband. Maybe you had a pen you wasn't supposed to have, or you had something hanging in your locker when you wasn't supposed to, and an asshole officer felt like writing you up that day. That's going to be your low-level write-ups. Now, the way it works in federal prison is you're going to have two different committees that will hear your case. Basically, for all the people that have been in the free world and have never been to prison, you're going to have two types of court that you can go to. Your first court is called UDC. The UDC just stands for Unit Disciplinary Committee, and it will be made up of people like your counselor, your unit manager, or your caseworker, or whoever that may be. It will be mostly the people that work your unit. So as an example, I was in B unit where I was at FCI Estill. My case manager was, let's just say, Mr. Smith. My unit manager was Mr. Davis, and they would be on the UDC committee if I ever got a shot and got rolled up, which I did several times. But that is who you will go see for your low-level offenses, for things that did not immediately get you arrested or locked up and taken off of the compound. Your ones and your 200s are usually don't pass go, don't collect $200, go straight to jail. They're going to lock you up on the spot because usually it's something to do with violence or, like I said, an escape attempt, whatever it may be. Tattooing, things like that. I'm pretty sure tattooing is a 200. Depending on who catches you doing that, you're going straight to the SHU. and you're going to have to see the DHO. Ones and 200s are going to go straight to DHO. Your threes and fours, it could go either way. Yes, you can go to the SHU for 300. You can even go to the SHU for several 400s. But usually, you'll stay free. You'll stay out on the compound, and you'll go see the UDC. And the UDC will make a recommendation. 9 times out of 10 for your 400s and a lot of your 300s, the UDC is just going to sentence you to something on the spot. They're going to be like 30 days phone restriction or commissary restriction, whatever it may be. And they're going to send you on about your way. Now, in some rare cases, the UDC can refer you to the DHO. So it's kind of like having a lower court and a higher court. Now, if the UDC has seen you too many times, even for low-level offenses, they can say, you know what, we're going to refer it to the DHO. And like I said, the difference, UDC, for the most part, is out here on the compound. You're still free. DHO is going to be in the SHU. That is like inside the jail or the prison. So if they refer you to the DHO, you do have to go over to the SHU. You got to go into a holding cell, and it's like having court. Now, the UDC can also recommend that you get locked up on the spot and go to the SHU to wait to see the DHO. But like I said, mostly how it works is UDC will give you something, send you on your way. If you do get referred to the DHO, most of the time you'll still stay free. They'll set you a date, and you have to go over there to the DHO. Now, when you go to the big court, which is the DHO, they can recommend you to stay. They can say, hey, you need to go over and be placed in segregation, whatever it is. You're already in there. It's easy to go ahead and lock you up. They know there's going to be no trouble. Now, the DHO is usually made up of a lieutenant. Mostly where I was at, it would be a lieutenant who was the DHO officer. I have seen it be unit managers and such as that, but there'll be one head DHO guy, and everybody on the compound will know who it is. And if you catch a bad one, I'm pretty sure that they rotate out. I don't know how often. I don't know if it's quarterly or whatever it is, but they do rotate out. But whenever you have a bad DHO, man, it's bad for everybody on the yard, because they usually don't cut no slack and no breaks, and they're going to send you to segregation off the rip no matter what. So just to recap real quick, that is how it works. That's how you can end up in the SHU. You catch a 200 or a 100 series, the high shots, you'll get arrested on the spot. If you're a fighter, you get into a fight, they're going to come, they're going to cuff you, they're going to take you over there, and you're going to go straight in. But if you get the threes and the 400s, you may not necessarily go right then, but you could get referred up, and then you could go in. Now, I'm going to break down what the SHU is like into two different parts here. Not two videos, just two different parts right now. The first part is going to be, intaking into the SHU, and then the second part will be what it's like spending time in there, days and everything like that. So first, you're going to do intake into the SHU. And basically, it's in the corner of the compound where I was at. So you go all the way to the top of the compound. You go over there in the corner by medical. They're going to open up this door. You're going to step into a sally port. It's just like coming into a jail. You'll go inside the sally port, and you'll be locked in between two sets of doors. You're going to be cuffed. And when they get you inside the inner door, they're going to take you into a waiting cell or a holding cell, whatever you want to call it. And you're going to go in there until the SHU officers are ready to get you basically booked in and get you into a cell. So depending on what kind of day it is and what's going on the compound, if there's no riots or anything, you could get processed in within the hour. But if some bad shit has happened and you're, like, say, a member of a big old fight and they got to process all these people, there's no telling how long you could be in this holding tank. So what will happen is they will come to your holding cell door. It doesn't matter if there's multiple of you in there. The time that I went to the SHU, there was four of us that worked medical, maybe five, I can't remember. And we were all in the holding cell at the same time. They're going to come, they're going to ask you what your jumpsuit size is, and they're going to shoot you some clothes through the bean hole. The bean hole is just a flat where you can get trays put in there. If you haven't eaten, they will shoot you a tray depending on what time it is and if there's food on the floor. You get all your clothes, and you're going to strip down right there and take off your compound uniform, which is tans. In the feds, in the mediums, and the penitentiaries, we wear khakis. You're going to take all that crap off. They're going to search you, make sure you don't have anything, and you're going to put that jumpsuit on. It doesn't matter how many people's in there. That is happening. And when you get into your jumpsuit, now you are ready. They're going to come around. They're going to let you know where you're going. They're going to give you a bedroll, which is basically your sheets, your blanket, and everything. You'll get some toothpaste and stuff like that to hold you over, because when you get locked up into the SHU, your property is still on the compound in the cell. you're going to have to count on that officer and your cellie to be a stand-up dude. If you had your locker open, which I do not recommend ever in prison, your cellie's going to have to be a stand-up dude that's not going to rob you and take all of your shit until the officer gets over there. Now, the normal protocol is that they'll lock the cell door knowing that you're in the hole. That way, nobody can rob you. But if they don't, guess what? You're just going to get screwed. But if you got a stand-up cellie, he'll make sure that all your shit is good. The officer will come, pack you out. They'll get your property over there, but sometimes you might not see it for up to a week. The process takes a while, man, depending on what's happening. So when you first come in, they will give you the basics, some soap, some toothpaste, and everything, and a bedroll. You're going to go to your cell. You don't know who you're going to be celling up with. In our case, we all worked together, and we all went to the SHU for something that was work-related, and they had completely empty cells, so they asked us who wanted to cell up together, and we all chose who we wanted to cell with, and that's where they put us. Now, I don't know how it is at all of the other BOP prisons, but I know at this prison, FCI Estill, your shower is inside your cell, so it eliminates the need to be able to bring guys outside the cell in cuffs and take them to showers that's at the end of the catwalk or the tier or wherever you are. There is an upstairs and downstairs. But your shower is inside your cell. And it's a push button shower, so you got to push it and it'll let out about 10 seconds of water and then it stops. Now there's ways around that, but that is for another video. I'll get into that later. There are tricks. So basically, when you walk into the SHU, you're going to see two beds. You're going to see the shower over here, and there's a little table around the corner on the back side of the shower, and then you've got your toilet and your sink, and that is it. There's a bean hole in the door. They're going to open that, and that's where they're going to shoot your food through, and that is where you're going to be 23 hours a day. Now they do rec call pretty much once a day. But even whenever you go outside, you're in just this cutout area in the middle of the building. So you're surrounded by concrete wall, but you're also inside of a dog cage. If any of you guys have ever seen these prison movies, that's pretty much how it is. They lock you inside of a cage. You can look up and see the sky, and you do get some fresh air. You get to feel the outside, but you do not get to see anything but the walls and the guys that are next to you in the cage. Now, everything that I'm describing to you right now is what you call administrative detention. And like I said before, this is before you've been sentenced. This is just if you're a threat to the security and they needed to remove you off the yard, or like I said, you got written up for something and you're locked up, or even if you got in a fight or whatever and they took you off the compound to put you here, you start off in the administrative side. And the administrative side is before you get sentenced. So you have a lot more of your privileges. When you finally do get your property, you'll be able to have a good bit of it. They'll let you have books. They'll let you have certain food items, drink items. And you can also do commissary. They do commissary once a week in the SHU. And you can order, I think, a $20 maximum of things like drink, coffee, little Tang juices. You can get like little squeezers of peanut butter, certain kinds of crackers, certain kinds of chips, honey buns, and things like that. So while you're on administrative, you're pretty good to go, man. It's kind of chill. Now, I say that it's kind of chill, and it is in your particular cell if you have a good cellie. But man, let me tell you, the SHU is hell around you, man. And the reason is that some guys sit in the SHU, man, for up to years. It's been done. It's happened. Guys back there get desperate, man. They get bored. Things are happening. People are beating on the walls, kicking the doors. You got guys going off. There's guys back there trying to commit suicide. There's guys back there successful in committing suicide. You've got cellies that will break off fighting. You've got guys that will try to fight even though they're cuffed whenever they're coming out trying to get on their way to rec. Especially these Hispanic gangs, man, who beef with each other. If they pass each other, even though they've got an officer, one on this guy and one, they'll try to hit. So it is just chaos all out and around you. There's noise constantly. It's almost 24/7, man. Nobody has any respect in the SHU, and it just doesn't matter. You may have a guy that decides he wants to be an asshole at 2:30 a.m., and he's going to get on that door, and he's going to kick that shit, and you're surrounded by nothing but concrete and metal so you can hear every single thing. Another thing that is bad back there is that if you need anything, if your cell is screwed up, if your toilet's flooding, you got shit and piss all in the floor, they don't really care, man. They'll get to it. They'll bring somebody over there, but they're not ready to jump to it and just get it fixed. The only way that it's going to be important to them is if it affects the officers that are back there. You got to realize the mentality. They already, a lot of those guys think that we're all pieces of shit for being in prison in the first place. And then when you further segregate yourself by screwing up and going to the SHU, you're really the worst of the worst. And it doesn't help the way that guys act back there. So if you're needing something, you're screwed. Now, once you get found guilty and you move over to disciplinary segregation, it's really bad because then you can't go to the commissary. You can't possess any of your food items or anything like that. The only thing you can have is a book. Now, you really want to talk about boring, possible desperation, man, depending on how long you got to do in there. You know, you can write letters. You can stay in contact with your family. Now, if you lose your phone privileges, you can't use the phone. But if you didn't lose your phone privileges, excuse me, they will bring a little phone around on wheels where you can call out, I think, once a week. But either way, it's even worse than the administrative side. You are complete solitude, man. All you can do is look at your four walls. You can grab you a shower to break up the monotony and the boredom. But dude, if the hot water runs out, then what do? Now, as far as the physical setup of the SHU and how it is, you come in, you've got like a central command or a control. And it's just like any other place. Hallways branch off. And I'm pretty sure that this SHU had two hallways. You got your downstairs and your upstairs in both halls. One hall is for the admin guys and the other hall is for the segregation after you've been sentenced. And that is the physical setup. And then kind of out in the middle area is where the recreation cages are. And that is pretty much it, guys. That is a pretty in-depth review of how it is in the SHU, man. It is not a place that you want to be. I spent approximately 30 days in there, give or take a couple, maybe 28, 29, maybe 31. I really can't remember. But my story of going to the SHU, I will tell in another video. And yes, believe it or not, I only went to the SHU one time while I was down. And it was for a crazy thing, and that's why I'm going to make a whole entire video about it, because the story leading up to why we win and everything is pretty dope. I hope you guys enjoyed this content for the day, man. I am going to be back with more. It is a new year, man, and we're ready to rock. Until next time.